I'd like to bring on next Natalie Mann. She is with Los Angeles County Public Works. And Natalie will be talking to you today about a trash monitoring program that they've been using, mobile apps, ArcGIS Collector in particular. So Natalie, if you're ready, go ahead and bring on your camera and we can share your screen and we'll let you take it away with your presentation.
Hi everyone. Okay, I think I'm here now. I hope everyone can hear me okay. So as Steve mentioned, my name is Natalie Mann. I work for the LA County Public Works ITGIS unit. So today we'll be talking about the trash monitoring program application and collector for ArcGIS. So I know a lot of us here have different backgrounds in GIS or are from different agencies and our experiences may vary with it. So Esri actually has a lot of tools that you may be able to use for mobile data collection and just visualizing data in different mapping applications. So aside from Collector, there are also solutions like Survey123, which is a bit more form-based. So if you have like a long form to fill out with a bunch of items to check, that may be more suited for you. But in the case of Collector, it's a little bit more map-focused. So that's what we're going to talk about today, is just a use case for Collector for ArcGIS. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get started. All right, so let's go to the next slide. Okay, so for the trash monitoring program, I just wanted to give you a bit of background info on just my experience, but also some of the application background information. So prior to joining the ITGIS unit, I actually was a IT student worker in LA County Public Works. So I used to go around and install and configure computer equipment for our users. So never did I imagine to end up where I am now. I think the most experience I ever had with GIS was installing ArcGIS for our users. But with solutions like these with Esri, there are a lot of things you can try to pick up and learn. So for the trash monitoring program, just to give some background on that, it actually was requested by our environmental programs division to replace their paper monitoring forms. So out in the field, they would report an illegal dumping issue on a piece of paper, bring it back to the office, and that's how it would get routed. So it was also at the time originally built in GeoCortex a few years back prior to when they had their GeoCortex Go app, which exists now. So that's why we decided to transition it to Collector at the time. And then it also allows field staff to report illegal dumping issues, like I mentioned, in Collector. And the whole premise of it was to get it integrated with an internal app that our office staff uses to report issues that they get from the public. So that's just a bit of background on how the project came about. Prior to this, just to give a little bit additional background info, I hadn't really worked with Collector too much. I did do a test app for catch basins inspections. It never went live, but it did give me enough of a foundation to kind of go with this project. So you'll see that kind of come to life in the next slides. All right. So next, just the components of the project. So like I mentioned, there was a need to integrate to an internal office application with this project. So we have a secured ArcGIS server service that is published to our department's ArcGIS server so that the users could report issues. There is offline capability enabled. So to do that, Esri has a lot of thorough documentation out there that I have linked in this presentation and I can share later. But basically, it encompasses enabling global IDs and archiving on your data sets, in this case, our enterprise geodatabase, the data set that we're using for this project, and publishing the map service with sync enabled and making sure that my web map had an offline base map. Again, this link will take you to more thorough documentation on that. And then also for our field staff and office staff who intended to use the application, we needed to make sure that they had a field worker type account, which allowed them to report and edit issues through things like Collector. So also with using the app, a lot of them primarily use iPhones and then also leverage ArcGIS Online through the web. Alrighty, so now we're kind of going to go into the Collector side of things. So I kind of mentioned the components of the project earlier. Here is what the maps look like when you go to Collector. So all of the users who need to work on the application are added to an ArcGIS Online group called Proj-EPD Collector, and they're able to see these maps. So there are two for this project. One is the field map called Field Use with Addresses. It has a lot more layers that the staff can refer to, such as public works facilities, sheriff stations, in addition to the reporting layers, just for their reference. And also a lot of them like to be able to identify parcels and addresses, which isn't taken offline for us just yet. So that's why it's in a separate map. For the offline field use map, we just have the reporting layers in there to minimize download times, because that's all they'll really need when they're working in remote areas like Malibu or the mountains, and they need to report issues and then sync their data back up once they get reception. And then lastly, with the app, there were multiple trainings provided, and I do have a thorough guide that I'll talk about shortly. So with a lot of these online solutions, they're really cool. They have a lot of capabilities, and it can be very overwhelming for staff who are used to maybe using paper forms to kind of get accommodated with it. So I'll go ahead and talk about that in a little bit. Right, next slide. So just to go into an overview, if you haven't used Collector before, what the app would look like for a user when reporting an issue, illegal dumping issue on their phones, it would kind of look like this. So I have a little test record here for you. So in the field, there's an add button in which they can add the issue type of their interest. In this case, this is an illegal dumping issue. So they can add a point to their map and then take a photo of the illegal dumping item when they're out in the field or attach anything relevant. In this example, I just took a picture of my keyboard because for testing. And then there's some fields that they can fill out with relevant information. So for the source, we marked it as TMP, indicating it's coming from the field or the mobile app. If anyone was to report in our internal application, it would indicate the internal app's name, which is solid waste issue tracking. We have an incident type, so it just shows that it's illegal dumping, and then you can mark a specific item that you see out there, like a cabinet. And then for the volume of items, this is just a way for our field users to kind of quantify how many items are out there. So again, with some of these drop-down menus, when there's a default or like something that occurs often, we just set a default value and they can change it. I just have it set by default to less than one dumpster. For illegal dumping issues, these are issues that occur not tied to places not tied to a property. So, you know, our road right of way or alley. So the location detail allows them to pinpoint maybe a more specific location of where the dumping has occurred. And then the priority, that defaults to normal, but if they have an emergency issue, they can indicate it as such if it needs to be addressed right away. For the follow-up, this is kind of what dictates the color of the issue or the symbology. When it's an issue that's been reported and is still out there, it'll be red. So if they went back and changed that later, when the issue's been picked up, it'll turn to green. You can dictate that with your configuring your service in your map document. And then lastly, for the description comments, we encourage users to leverage the section to add more information about their issue. For here, I just say test, but if they wanted the waste hauler, the office staff to know a little bit more about the issue itself, like if it's a refrigerator with doors attached, or there's additional items out there, or the whole alley is kind of filled with items, then they can use that section. So this is kind of a preview of what it's like to report an issue in the Collector app. All right, so next we're going to go into the user guide. So as I mentioned earlier, when users are transitioning from something like a paper form on a daily basis to using a mobile app like Collector, and if they're not the most tech savvy, it's helpful to have frequent trainings or refreshers and documentations to kind of get them up to speed. Now, in this screenshot I have here, you can see that the guide goes up to 30 pages, and that's a lot. I understand that. But sometimes when we're learning something new, at least for me, I like to have something available that can walk me through it step by step without missing something. And that's what I tried to cover in this documentation. I wanted to be as thorough as possible, and I wanted to walk them through it from signing into the app to reporting an issue to cool features that Collector has. Because when you have a training going through something new, it can be very, very, very overwhelming to just go through all of that. So it's nice to have something to refer back to if they wanted out in the field. So yeah, that's what the documentation covers. It's also worthwhile to have documentation for your colleagues or for other projects. So if my colleagues wanted to know what the app was like and what it does, I could easily pull up this documentation, and they could also use it for other use cases for their projects. So big fan of documentation, and it does help the users out in the field. And it also provides somewhat of an agenda when we are doing training. So we can refer to this page when we're starting to report an issue and stuff like that. So that's been helpful in getting the users accommodated with the application. All right, next. So for the web app builder or office portion of it, I created this app in ArcGIS Online. And it shows basically an attribute table of all the issues that get reported in real time. As you can see, it's a little bit small, I know, in the presentation, but I show an attribute table with all the issues that come in, and the attachments are linked if they're available. And there are some widgets available in which they could use to query or filter data of their interest. So they could search up certain case numbers, who reported the issue. And prior to integrating with the internal app that I mentioned earlier, there was a bit of a disconnect. So the office staff would use this web app to view any data reported in the field. Now they just use that office app that we have, but this is just a good, this was a good solution for them to be able to view data in the office. And even now, like when we're working from home and some people didn't initially have VPN access, this was a useful tool for them to see what's going on in the field. So Web App Builder is not the only solution out there that ArcGIS Online provides. If you needed office staff to view what was going on, there are also operations dashboards. Our road maintenance division leverages that a lot for their projects such as their tree inventory and different like emergency response events. Dashboards are also a good way to visualize data from the office. All right, so next, we're going to talk about some challenges and learning moments. Again, I know all of us are in different spectrums of our careers, education, exposure to GIS. So like I mentioned before, again, there was some initial resistance from our field users, and there needed to be extensive training. They were used to the workflows with paper, and sometimes you know, the app doesn't work if they're not using offline mode, and there were some bugs. So, you know, getting them warmed up to it took some time. And it just was a matter of not only going to the through the trainings and providing the documentation, but being available through a phone call, a lot of visits at my desk, trying to make sure that we gave some individualized attention to what they were having trouble with. Since the project has deployed, it's been a lot more stable. I don't get as many calls anymore, except for maybe when they forget how to log in. And that's when I get to be like, let's pull out the guide and go through it together again. And that's always helpful. And as I mentioned earlier, before we integrated fully with the office application I mentioned called Solid Waste Issue Tracking, we did need to have an intermediate solution for getting our office staff to view the field cases in the meantime. So we leveraged Web App Builder. We did some temporary compliance reports that would fire off emails of what's been reported. So that was just something that we had to do in the meantime. So ideally, we would have wanted to deploy at the same time, but you know, things come up. I just wanted to give a big shout out to Peter, my project partner who works on the office solution. He's awesome. I don't know if he's here, but he is a mastermind in getting this application to work. So although Collector is one big portion of it, without his application, we wouldn't get automated emails to the waste haulers or office staff anytime someone reports something out in the field. And that really streamlines the communication to our waste haulers to address these issues in our waste service collection areas. So thanks, Peter. And then the other thing is with the app and with the benefits of Collector, I think a lot of other users, divisions are seeing how it could benefit their workflows. And for us, with this project, we had growing use by field staff. So we had some staff on loan who would help report these issues. And there are times that we encountered some performance issues as well. So we did have some trouble over the summer with some performance with our ArcGIS server. But we had a lot of team support from our enterprise GIS team. They helped us get things up and running. And like I said, things are stable. So a lot of these aspects are very much a team effort. With ArcGIS server services and collector, you may not always encounter those issues. It just depends on the use case. Again, because I had a need to integrate with an internal app, we just went that route. However, divisions in our department, like road maintenance, they leverage hosted feature layers on ArcGIS Online, which allows them to just avoid kind of those issues with the server. And it's a little bit more seamless when they work offline. So again, it just depends on your use case. And then the other thing is we had to accommodate for additional requests from the division. So we still meet with them every week just in case they have any desired enhancements, and that's always ongoing. And also just accommodating for bugs. So the really only noteworthy, the biggest bug I think that I wanted to share was taking the feature services offline if you have a reference to the same feature class in your map document. So you're not able to take those offline. It's an enhancement that was logged, but the workaround for that for me was to just publish separate map services for each reference to that same feature class. So that allowed me to take things offline just fine. But again, if you are working in with ArcGIS Online hosted feature layers, it shouldn't be as much of an issue, I don't think. So that's just something I wanted to share. I had a lot of support from Esri as well. I know with a lot of these tools, there are so many things you can do, but you just may not know exactly how to get to it yet. So if you do have Esri support, I strongly encourage it. I don't think I would have been able to get this project fully running and operational without the support of the Esri analysts that I got to work with. So I just got really fortunate to be able to work with some awesome people. So those are some challenges and learning moments that I wanted to share. So just some things about the road ahead for this application. So recently we started communicating with some waste haulers about getting them to use Collector as well. So I talked with our business division, environmental programs, and Republic Services a couple months ago just to show them how Collector works and how it may work for them when resolving issues out in the field. They're still touching base with their managers, their users about getting that up and running. So that's a potential thing that'll be coming down the pipeline. The other thing is, I'm not sure if anyone has seen, but Esri released an article earlier this month about ArcGIS field maps, and field maps kind of combine some of the functionalities of Collector, Tracker, and Explorer, I believe. So with those capabilities, it's something I want to explore just because I would like to transition TMP to this eventually if Collector gets phased out, and just leverage some of the cool features that that will have. So that's down the pipeline for me, and there will be a lot of research to be done there on my end. So for the most part, that is the presentation, but I just wanted to share a quick conclusion. Here's my contact info. Again, I think there's so much that you can do and leverage with Esri solutions, and you may not have to be the most tech-savvy GIS person out there. You can pick it up, and with the support of like colleagues from other departments, agencies, and Esri, you really can get a cool and useful application going, just like TMP. There's still a lot of users who call and ask questions that I may not know, that I have not tried, but we're very encouraged to kind of learn and try things together, and tools like this going to help our department function more efficiently. I'm just grateful that you made it through this presentation. Thanks to everyone who supported for it. And I think we can go to Q&A if ready.
Yeah, well, very good, Natalie. That was very exciting to see how you're deploying mobile apps out there in the field and with the workforce. to make things a little bit more efficient all the way across. So we do have a question you partially addressed already about moving to ArcGIS field maps, and maybe even and also the question goes on to ask, are you using Workforce as part of the coordination of the field application or deploying people? And Natalie seems to be frozen. Up there, are you back?
I'm sorry, my internet connection dropped temporarily.
Perfect timing. This is the virtual world we're in. Okay, so let me restate it. So you addressed going to field maps and some of the advantages there. Greg Mattis is also asking if you are using Workforce or Survey123 to collect reports from the public, or if you're using Workforce on managing the field deployment at all.
So for this project and for the projects that I have, I'm not working on Workforce, but we do have our route maintenance division who they've dabbled in Workforce, so they may be a better contact for that. But for Survey123, we do have some active projects pending for some of inspection forms and things of that nature. So we do dabble in that a bit.
Very good. And I think Nick has a question he wanted to ask. It came through a different channel. Nick, do you want to open your mic and ask?
Yeah, if I could, that's what I thought. I figured I would do instead of throwing it in there, because as a panelist, it doesn't let me actually ask the question in there. So Natalie in Public Works, I just wanted to give you guys a shout out for your work on Collector, specifically helping our department after the Woolsey fire. We did a windshield survey. We created an app, and your department, your team had a big head start on us and helped us out. And the user guide, I put it in the chat there, but I think the user guide is also very, as easy as the application is and as user-friendly as it is, to make that guide and to still make it specific to that app that project you're working on is really good. So kudos to your documentation and to all the work you guys are doing on this. So thank you very much.
Thanks, Nick. Oh, yeah. And Stephen Gutierrez isn't here, I don't think, but he's from our route maintenance division and works a lot with these applications as well. And they've done some amazing work. So just wanted to highlight that as well.
And we have one more question for you, Natalie, from Luis Valero. He says, you mentioned field staff are added to a county ArcGIS group to view the pertinent maps in Collector. Does each user added require their own ArcGIS license?
Yeah, so for ArcGIS Online, they're named user accounts. So each person does need their own license or account.
Okay. So, and I think, yeah, that's when you're looking at field apps, that's one of the decision points is, you know, Collector and some of these are license accounts and others are like Survey123, you can deploy more openly to the public. So I think, you know, each of these applications like DPW is using depends on the use case, but a great question. And I think it's important to discuss where the right tool fits the job. So are there any other questions for Natalie? You have a minute or so to pop anything else in the box, but I'll ask you one in the meantime, which is, as you've been working with folks on the mobile apps who aren't necessarily GIS people or GIS, you know, savvy, have you seen a good uptake? Are people finding, or are you seeing, you know, reluctance to try to go digital and mobile? How's that worked?
Initially there was, but I don't think they were, for some divisions or departments, they use GIS a bit more. So you'll definitely encounter people who are more open, but over time it's a lot more stable. They're okay with using it. They're comfortable now. So it does take some warming up, and it just depends on the person. It's a case by case basis, I'm finding.
Absolutely. No, and I think that's a common thing is, you know, we see that is as you introduce these new tools and technologies to staff who aren't used to using them, whether it's internal or external with the public, it does take a learning curve. So I think we're all, and Isaac talked about this too, we're all trying to get more of our colleagues and constituents familiar with how these data are useful across so many applications. And I think this is a great example of mobile apps in a workflow that's very ideal.